knows everything he's done, and he thought he was going to get away with it.
If that were me, and I truly believe that to my heart and my core, I would be saying the same thing to you guys.
We don't really have to take the family's word for it, but Claude himself admitted to me that he would fly off the handle and break dishes and throw things. But most importantly, here's a police report by my lawyer. And it, she tells officers that Claude did hit her in the face.
Anybody besides Claude, Lori, and God ever answered that question?
But according to this police report, Lori says that Claude assaulted her. These are her words. We both agree that this evidence strongly suggests that Claude was an abuser. And we just don't think that this lead will work for you. Then lastly, was that if the prosecution's theory was correct, and Claude locked Lori into that storage room, then she shouldn't have any burns on her body. That's because the fire never actually made it into that room. But we brought in a well-renowned medical examiner. She looked at the evidence in this case, and she says Lori's injuries could have come from superheated air. It didn't have to come from the flames itself.
But if all of your body is in the same temperature of air, how is that specifically putting burns on certain spots?
You can protect parts of your body by wearing, you know, certain articles of clothing. She was also hiding behind a washing machine. And it seems she covered herself with some water. That could have shielded herself. But the medical examiner saw something else that concerned her. Now, based on Claude's story, he and Lori made it right up to the front door, right by the fire. They're walking single file. She's pressed right up against his body. She's not wearing pants. The flames are so intense. Claude works the door open. She panics and then turns back and runs towards the fire. If that's true, how does she not have burns on her bare legs? Why is Claude's hair singed by the flames and hers is not? We just want to give you the information that we have.
Yeah, and we ask you to give it to us.
Give it to us, great.
It's just a lot.
Let's take a look at the two scenarios that were presented at court. The prosecution argued that Claude locked Lori in the storage room